It's your boy Nikur in the house, back with another Arsenal News episode. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be something really special as to what you guys will realize what is exactly happening with us, because we are definitely going to talk about Poland Balogun in this episode. Of course, we're going to talk about Mikel Aziz. Mikel Arteta and everyone has responded to Thomas Partey not having a wonderful game against Slavia Prague. And of course, the return of the next week's reverse fixture of the Europa League. And of course, the upcoming game on Sunday against Sheffield United. So we're going to talk about that. Sheffield United manager has actually blabbered something about Arsenal. We're going to talk about that. And of course, three transfer news as well. So without any further ado, let's just jump into it. And of course, some good news that Boris Johnson has actually announced that a set of 10,000 fans might be allowed into the stadium as early as May. Yeah, we would have to discuss that as well. So let's just jump into the first news that we got for you guys. Here is Poland Balogun. Well, this is the reality about from AD editor ANS has actually responded. He says exclusively that Poland Balogun will have media duties on his new four-year deal on Tuesday. Arsenal will announce the news on their website on Wednesday. So on Tuesday, on the record, Poland Balogun will come on record and say that he's accepted the new deal with Arsenal. And on Wednesday, Arsenal will announce the news on their website. So done and dusted. Another Arteta masterclass. Poland Balogun will commit his future with Arsenal. Moving on, so Mikel Aziz has shared certain Europa League images, the training images that he's actually pretty much he was excited to be named at least on the bench for Arsenal in the game against Slavia Prague. So these are the images that he has shared on social media with all the Arsenal fans. So along with Joel Lopez, who also was named on the bench for the first time. So this is something really cool, isn't it? The youngsters are having a very good time, I say. That's kind of cool. Yeah, let's go on for it. Moving on. So another transfer to start with, the first transfer news of the night, of the day. Sorry, Christopher Onkunku is indeed on Arsenal's list of potential targets. This is according to Christian Folk, so you better believe this. Christopher Nkunku is indeed on Arsenal's list of potential targets, and they would certainly represent the kind of step up that he's looking for. Nkunku has a 40 million euros market value and is on departure list for RB Leipzig. Christian Folk also says that there are, of course, alternatives. Julian Draxler is available on a free transfer, or Julian Brandt, who is on the cut list at Dortmund. So Draxler, Onkunku, and of course Julian Brandt, the players that we can actually enter Arsenal and the players that are actually in the radar. So Christopher Onkunku to Arsenal is also the talk of the town. It is, I'm not joking. Yeah, the rumors are back, and this time I think they're here to stay for some time. Very well. Moving on, so Martin Keown has opened up about Nicola Pepe. He says, "What I will say about Pepe, it doesn't matter how many times you knock him or leave him out. When he comes on, he's capable of doing something like scoring a goal." And also Mikel Arteta had something to say about Nicola Pepe as well. He says, "He has been really effective when he has come on as a sub and started against Liverpool, and now he needs to be at that consistent level. We know that he's a threat. He has more goals than any other winger that we have, and that's a big plus for us." I'm talking about Thomas Partey, Arteta said, "Hopefully on Sunday and next Thursday, you can see the best version of Thomas. Now he has got a sequence of two or three games apart from the international break. I think you will see that he will finish the season in a really strong way. He is still adapting to our way of playing. He had some big sparks, and we can all see what he can bring to the team. Now it is about finding that consistency level and that we need from him, and building a team that can play around him, because he has that capacity." Let's see for how long does that capacity last long. Well, talking about capacity, is Paul Heckenbottom, the new Sheffield United manager, gives frank word on Mikel Arteta's Arsenal ahead of Sheffield United clash, as if nobody was asking to him about it. So since he became the caretaker manager, Sheffield are yet to see his side win the game, and since the game is at Bramall Lane, he actually has his say about Mikel Arteta. He says, "You can say that, but we are at the stage of the season where you are where you deserve to be." When asked if Arsenal were underachieving, he says, "You have seen in their games, they can really open you up. There have been questions. There are moments where when they can blow teams away. When we have to try and make them not be that good and play on the back foot while keeping an eye on those players. They have they have who can produce a bit of magic and take a game away from you. However, he says that there are weaknesses within the Arsenal side that Sheffield United will look to exploit. He says, we will obviously try to. We have seen a few changes in their game. Sometimes they go short, but they have also started going a bit long. We have to prepare for both. If we have to press high, we have to be ready for that. If they are going to take that option away and go longer, then we have to be ready for that. You have to accept that Arsenal are going to get through you. They do that every time. People will always highlight the negatives, but they can create a lot of chances at the top end of the page. So Heckenbottom says about it. He says, we would love a repeat of that performance and result. We know the one thing that is missing is the fans. That atmosphere is electric. But as it stands on Sunday, we won't have that. But we can control, what we can control is our feelings and try and draw on those miracles and memories. We are going to prepare the best we can to give that type of performance, the performance that they produced last season. But moving on, so it looks like Arsenal could actually seal £39.9 million transfer masterstroke in the summer window after Dortmund decision. Now, Borussia Dortmund midfielder Julian Brandt was a name consistently linked with Arsenal in the January transfer window. Now, Brandt opted to stay and fight for his place at Borussia and has been rewarded for his efforts, making 25 league appearances this season. Now, he boasts 2 goals and 1 assist in the collective 35 appearance. Not that good for his name. But if Arsenal are priced out of the permanent deal for on loan Martin Odegaard, Arteta, along with technical director Edu, will have little choice but to look elsewhere to add creativity. Now, Football London previously reported that Dortmund could part ways with Brandt for around €25 million, which is significantly lower than what the player is valued at. CIES, otherwise known as Football Observatory, values Brandt at a staggering €69.3 million with a 24-year-old under contract until 2024 at Dortmund. So, but even a conservative valuation from transfer market sits at around €35 million, which means any way you cut it, Arsenal would be getting a bargain at a transfer window. Now, in fact, going from the Football Observatory valuation, Arsenal would be getting a bargain worth roughly £39.99 million. Yep, that's what they would suggest as well. So that is the price tag of Julian Brandt. Arsenal are interested, but their whole eyes are set on Martin Odegaard right now. So let's see what happens. Moving on, so Villarreal have set the asking price for Pau Torres. Now, Villarreal are willing to accept a bid lower than Pau Torres' release clause, with Manchester United, Real Madrid ready to pounce for his signature, and also Arsenal in the mix in the past as well. So the 24-year-old has become one of the most highly rated young centre-backs in Europe over the last 2 seasons, when he has become a regular for the Yellow Submarines. Now, he's actually keen to make the next step in his career, but is hoping that they will not be put off by his €65 million release clause, that is £56 million. ESPN report that Villarreal will be persuaded to sell for a bid closer to €50 million, with the defender looking to make a move. So €50 million is the price tag for Villarreal's centre-back Pau Torres. The imposing centre-back is under contract at the club until 2024, so they are under no pressure to sell. But if a club is interested, they would come and get it. They would come and get him. And it's a come and get him play for €50 million. If you want some, come get some. Moving on, so Boris Johnson has confirmed 10,000 spectators to be allowed inside stadiums from May 17th. Now, up to 10,000 fans will be allowed back into the English stadiums in step 3 of the easing of the coronavirus restrictions, with plans to allow even more spectators following a series of pilots. Now, Prime Minister Boris Johnson outlined his roadmap out of lockdown. The government will allow up to 10,000 fans or 1/4 capacity at the stadiums that holds less than 40,000 spectators to attend events from May 17th onwards. The final day of the Premier League season is scheduled to take place on May 23rd, meaning thousands of supporters could see their team in action before the close of current campaign. There is a possibility that more than 10,000 fans will be allowed at a bigger stadiums, with government confirming that they would run several pilot schemes to see if larger gatherings would be possible or not. Now, government say that they will use enhanced testing approaches and other measures to run events with larger crowd sizes and reduce social distancing to evaluate the outcomes. Pilots will start only in April, by the way. And the news is also a huge boost to England's hopes of hosting European Championships this summer, with Wembley the venue for both the semi-finals and the finals. Let's see what happens to Johnson's roadmap. So The actual rules are that 1,000 people or half the venue's capacity for indoor events, 10,000 people or 25% of the capacity for seated events at larger venues, 4,000 people or half capacity for other outdoor events. That's what it is. So with this, we end this episode. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you seek daily awesome content, best place to be considered subscribing. I will see you in the next one. Cheers.